Broccoli fights cancer. Surprising discovery reveals how broccoli fights cancer. Broccoli, and to an even greater degree broccoli sprouts, has gained a reputation as a potent cancer fighter, and recent research sheds new light on the actual mechanics behind its chemoprotective abilities. One of the compounds in broccoli known to have anti-cancer activity is sulforaphane, a naturally occurring organic sulfur. Studies have shown sulforaphane supports normal cell function and division while causing apoptosis, programmed cell death, in colon, prostate, breast and tobacco-induced lung cancer cells, and reducing the number of cancerous liver tumors in mice. 3 servings of broccoli per week may reduce your risk of prostate cancer by more than 60%. Now, Oregon State University, OSU, researchers believe they've discovered yet another way sulforaphane works to protect you against cancer. How sulforaphane prevents cancer from spreading. Scientists at OSU discovered that sulforaphane significantly reduces the expression of oncogenes, long non-coding RNA, in prostate cancer cells, thereby influencing the miRNA, microRNA, and reducing the cancer cell's ability to form colonies by as much as 400%. So much for junk DNA. Lead OSU investigator Emily Ho, PhD, commented on her team's findings, saying, "It's obviously of interest that this dietary compound, found at some of its highest levels in broccoli, can affect oncogenes. This could open the door to a whole range of new dietary strategies, foods or drugs that might play a role in cancer suppression or therapeutic control." According to Medical News Today, oncogenes have increasingly emerged as key players in the development of numerous cancers, primarily by regulating gene expression. They primarily regulate gene expression negatively by either degrading or inducing translational repression in the messenger RNA. Sulforaphane combats cancer in more ways than one. Sulforaphane also reduces damaging reactive oxygen species, ROS, by as much as 73%, thereby lowering your risk of inflammation, another hallmark of cancer. It's also an immune stimulant, and having robust immune function is your first line of defense against not only cancer but all disease. Sulfur-rich cruciferous vegetables such as broccoli also play an important role in detoxification, which is yet another factor that can affect your cancer risk. Broccoli sprouts, in particular, have been shown to help detox environmental pollutants such as benzene. As noted by the World's Healthiest Foods, sulforaphane increases the activity of the liver's phase II detoxification enzymes. These enzymes are well known for their ability to clear a wide variety of toxic compounds from the body, including not only many carcinogens, but also many reactive oxygen species, a particularly nasty type of free radical. By jumpstarting these important detoxification enzymes, compounds in crucifers provide protection against cell mutations, cancer and numerous other harmful effects that would otherwise be caused by these toxins. Other anti-cancer compounds in broccoli. Aside from sulforaphane, broccoli contains several other health-promoting, chemoprotective nutrients and compounds, including fiber, which helps nourish your gut microbiome to strengthen your immune function and reduce your risk of inflammatory diseases. Fiber also activates a gene called TBET, which is essential for producing immune cells in the lining of your digestive tract. These immune cells, called innate lymphoid cells, ILCs, help maintain balance between immunity and inflammation in your body and produce interleukin-22, IL-22, a hormone that helps protect your body from pathogenic bacteria. ILCs even help resolve cancerous lesions and prevent the development of bowel cancers and other inflammatory diseases. Glucuronephrin, a glucosinolate precursor of sulforaphane that influences carcinogenesis and mutagenesis. Compared to mature broccoli, broccoli sprouts can contain up to 20 times more glucuronephrin. Phenolic compounds, including flavonoids and phenolic acids, which have a potent ability to eliminate damaging free radicals and quell inflammation, resulting in a lower risk for diseases such as asthma, type 2 diabetes and heart disease. One of the ways phenolic compounds slow the encroachment of disease is by defending against infection, most dramatically by zapping ROS linked to atherosclerosis and neurodegenerative diseases such as Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. Diindolylmethane, DIM. Your body produces DIM when it breaks down cruciferous vegetables. Like many other broccoli compounds, DIM has shown multiple potential benefits, including boosting your immune system and helping to prevent or treat cancer. Nicotinamide mononucleotide, NMN, an enzyme involved in the production of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, NAD, a compound involved in mitochondrial health and energy metabolism. NAD may slow age-related decline in health by restoring your metabolism to more youthful levels. Previous research has shown that, with age, your body loses its capacity to create NAD, an effect thought to be related to, or the result of, chronic inflammation. Studies have also shown that taking NAD directly is ineffective. Instead, you're better off taking its precursor, NMN, found in broccoli, cucumbers, cabbage, avocado and other green vegetables. Once in your system, NMN is quickly converted into NAD. Broccoli reduces risk of fatty liver and liver cancer. Broccoli may also be an important dietary intervention for non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, NIFLD, which affects up to 25% of Americans, including children. NIFLD is defined as an excessive accumulation of fats in your liver in the absence of significant alcohol consumption. The overconsumption of net carbs, especially fructose from processed foods, soda and juices, is strongly associated with NIFLD which, if left untreated, can raise your risk of liver cancer. Recent research suggests the fat-forming and pro-inflammatory effects of fructose may be due to transient ATP, the chemical storage form of energy, depletion. This in turn leads to uric acid formation, which at excessively high levels acts as a pro-oxidant inside your cells. According to an animal study published in 2016, long-term consumption of broccoli may reduce your chances of developing fatty liver and liver cancer caused by the standard American diet by lowering triglyceride levels in your liver. How to optimize sulforaphane content in mature broccoli? Ideally, broccoli should not be eaten raw. If you prefer raw food, you'd be better off eating raw broccoli sprouts instead of mature broccoli, as they're a far more potent source of sulforaphane. Tests show 3-day-old broccoli sprouts consistently contain up to 50 times the amount of anti-cancer compounds found in mature broccoli, including sulforaphane. This supercharged nutrient density means you can eat far less of them while still maximizing your benefits. If you're partial to mature broccoli, you can maximize the sulforaphane content by preparing it properly, and combining it with specific foods. Eating broccoli raw will actually only give you about 12% of the total sulforaphane content theoretically available. Research shows steaming mature broccoli spears for 3 to 4 minutes will increase the available sulforaphane content by eliminating epithiospecifier protein, a heat-sensitive sulfur-grabbing protein that inactivates sulforaphane, while still retaining the enzyme myrosinase, which converts glucuronine to sulforaphane. The latter is important because, without myrosinase, you cannot absorb the sulforaphane. Do not steam the broccoli for more than 5 minutes, however, as beyond that point, you start losing valuable compounds. If you want to microwave your broccoli, be sure not to go past the 1-minute mark, as this will destroy a majority of the myrosinase needed for sulforaphane absorption. If you opt for boiling, blanch it in boiling water for no more than 20 to 30 seconds, then immerse it in cold water to stop the cooking process. Also, be sure to use raw, freshly harvested broccoli whenever possible. Frozen broccoli has diminished ability to produce sulforaphane as myrosinase is quickly destroyed during the blanching process. Broccoli can also lose 80% of its glucuronine, the precursor of sulforaphane, in the first 10 days after harvest. To increase sulforaphane content even further, eat it with a myrosinase-containing food such as mustard seed, daikon radishes, wasabi, arugula or coleslaw. A 2013 study that focused on mustard seed, which is said to contain a particularly resilient form of myrosinase, confirmed that mustard seed can boost sulforaphane formation even in boiled broccoli. Adding a myrosinase-rich food is particularly important if you eat the broccoli raw or use frozen broccoli. Clean your colon, flatten your belly, and remove fat with this marvelous and healthy shake. Nowadays, a lot of attention is given to the importance of leading a healthy lifestyle. But, only few of us know what this actually means. A healthy lifestyle means leading a healthy diet comprised of healthy foods and drinks and being physically active on a regular basis. When we establish this type of routine in our lives, we help our organs function properly and we reduce the risk of poor overall health. Toxic deposits in the body. Unfortunately, a lot of health problems such as obesity and organ damage appear as a result of too many toxins in the body. Although different organs are affected, the one which suffers the most is the colon. Therefore, first, You need to find the right method to cleanse the colon and then eliminate toxins from the whole body. In return, this will result in less body fat and a flat belly. You can achieve this with the help of a powerful colon cleanse remedy. This homemade shake is rich in natural ingredients that will burn surplus fat and nourish the body. It's rich in vitamins, nutrients, and minerals, and it's really tasty. Besides cleaning your colon, it will also remove toxins from the digestive system. Let's take a look at the recipe now. 1/2 cup of gluten-free oatmeal. 3/4 cup of papaya. 1/2 cup of water or almond milk. 1/4 tablespoon of cinnamon powder. Preparation: blend the ingredients in a blender until you get a homogeneous mixture. Additional tip: if you want a sweeter taste, add some raw honey. Drink 1 glass of the shake every morning before breakfast.